Mark, tell us a little bit about the other half of the alchemy architecture mix that you started speaking about earlier. What's the architecture piece to it?
Well, so if the alchemy is the soft stuff, the culture, the climate, the ethos, the feel, the architecture is the hard stuff.
Yeah.
You can generally hold it in your hand.
Okay.
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 So it's a list of kits.
Okay.
So that's the database system.
Gotcha.
So as we distributed to the group today, we have this document called the 17 systems. And so each one of those systems, like the 13 or 14 systems of the body, they work in concert with each other. But so you hold that in your hand. There's also the calendar system. You feel it?
Yeah.
You can hold it in your hand.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a volunteer recruitment system. Now you say, well, no, you want to have it written down.
Mm-hmm.
What are your needs? What's your pool? Who's you gonna, right?
Yeah.
It's, you can hold it. You're working a process.
Yeah.
You know, the hospitality system, you know, what are we doing so that what do you have written down in terms of our protocols when a new kid walks in the room, what's happening?
Yeah.
And what's the follow-up and who's responsible for them? Do we send them some bread or a postcard or a Starbucks gift card? Right? Some plan. Most churches wish they had a plan and know they should have a plan.
Mm.
It's just willy-nilly. Like, oh, this Sunday school teacher sends a personal note.
Mm.
This one never does anything. They just talk to the kids they know.
Mm.
So it's actually having a plan. You know, a facility system, a student leadership system. How do we, you know, what's our plan for empowering students to be agents of mission?
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's the thing about student leadership. It has a shelf life of 6 months. There are two kinds of student leadership programs that we've seen. One of them is, we used to do that, but we're not doing it anymore. The other is, we just started this new thing and we're real excited about it.
Mm, sure.
But most churches can't sustain a single student leadership model for more than 6 months. So why don't we design a student leadership system built around that reality?
Right.
So we have kids plug in for 6 months, or 4 or 5 months, take a few months off and do a whole nother group, right?
Yeah.
Just like they sign up for a sport and then take a little time off and sign up for, not being a play here and they're playing football here.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, those are, so the idea behind the architecture is that the more we can define or at least sketch out, I mean, you can't get A+ on all 17 of these as you're starting out.
Sure.
What you can do is get them all up to functional.
Yeah.
Right?
Give them a C.
Right. Let's get to A+ on database.
Yeah.
Let's get to A+ on calendar. And let's get to A+ on volunteer recruiting.
Mm-hmm.
And then let the others just get improved every year.
Sure.
We have another tool we call the preventative maintenance calendar, which essentially is the tool that reminds us to tend to each of those systems at some point during the year. So we might say, every July, we update the database.
Right.
And every January, we update the calendar, right? So the idea is to you don't have to build a perfect system because, you know, perfection is the enemy of getting something done.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
And a lot of times, our inner critic is even louder than the people that criticize us. But, you know, people can say, well, I mean, that's pretty disorganized. Well,
right.
let's have it at least to a C level, knowing that it's not perfect, but it's a heck of a lot better than doing nothing, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's the architecture is much more straightforward and requires, nobody's going to mind. You're not going to create resistance by tending to your database.
Sure.
Right? When you're changing culture, you're going to get resistance.
Sure.
But when you're just building this infrastructure, you're just giving yourself a really solid place for from which to do ministry.
Yeah, yeah. Ron Heifetz's work comes to mind in talking about technical change and adaptive change.
Right.
And I don't know if this is an easy analogy to make, but what I'm hearing is the architecture work is kind of the technical fixes which need to be there, that absolutely need to be there because they're sort of the skeleton of the whole body. But the adaptive change is the alchemy piece that's challenging.
That's a great way to think about it. Yeah. I love that.
Yeah.
And a lot of times the adaptive change is really just technical solutions rearranged.
Right.
Right. Right. So, but you can't rearrange them if you don't have them.
Sure.
Right. You couldn't create the iPod if you didn't have all the component parts. Right.
Right.
They just rearranged them for the most part.
Right. Right. Yeah.
And so the it's not like we have to have this grand aha. It's just that if we're gonna create culture change, if we're gonna do something innovative, we've got to have these tools at our fingertips to arrange, rearrange multiple times to get to a different result.
Yeah.